Learn how to build interactive Excel charts using a combo box and dynamic data ranges. By selecting a name in the combo box, you can instantly view and compare specific data on the chart. We'll start with a brief explanation of the offset function, which is used to create dynamic ranges. This approach gives you the flexibility to work with changing data while keeping your charts responsive and interactive. The offset function allows you to return a reference to a range that is a certain number of rows and columns away from a given starting point. It takes 5 arguments to determine the range to reference. Here's what each argument of the formula means. Starting reference. This is the point from which the offset begins. In this case, it's cell A2. Row offset. This specifies how many rows to move from the starting reference. Since B12 is used, the number of rows to move is whatever value is in cell B12. If B12 contains a 1, then you'd move 1 row down from A2, landing on A3. Column offset. This indicates how many columns to move from the starting reference. Since it's set to 0, you don't move horizontally. You stay in the same column. Height. This determines the number of rows that the offset range should include. With a value of 1, the range is 1 row tall. Width. This determines the number of columns that the offset range should include. With a value of 1, the range is 1 column wide. To illustrate how the offset function can dynamically change the reference cell based on the value in another cell, enter 1 in B12 cell, then input the formula in D14 cell. D14 will display the content of cell A3 because it offsets 1 row from the base point at A2. Let's enter another offset formula in cell D15 with the same arguments, but change the column offset to 1 and the column width to 4. This updated formula extends the range across 4 columns, resulting in a single row with 4 columns. If you enter 2 in B12 cell, D15 will then display the content from the range B4 to E4. Similarly, if you enter 3, D15 will show the range B5 to E5. Next, add a clustered column chart using the range A8 to E10 as shown on the screen. For now, you can insert the chart by selecting any row in the average row. Later, we will use dynamic ranges to adjust the chart's display based on the combo box selection. Next, go to the Developer tab, select the combo box icon from the Insert dropdown and insert it on the chart. Right-click on the combo box and choose Format Control. Select range A3 to A8 for the input range and select Enter B12 cell for the cell link. The dynamic ranges will use the value of cell B12 to determine the row offset. Adjust the combo box's width and height. Also rename chart title. Next, go to the Formulas tab and select Define Name. Name the range names. In the Refers to box, enter the formula shown on the screen. Repeat these steps to define another dynamic range. Name the range data. In the Refers to box, enter the formula shown on the screen. Right-click on the chart and click Select Data from the context menu. Edit First Series in the Edit Series box. Enter the dynamic range name names into the series name box. Enter the second dynamic range name data in the series values box. Click OK. Now, edit the horizontal category axis labels and select the top heading range B2 to F2 and press OK. Clicking the downward pointing arrow on the combo box shown on the graph will update the chart based on the selected name. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel.